Situated off the Devon coast, surrounded by clear turquoise waters and circling birds, sits Lundy Island. Dramatic scenery and big open spaces attract a significant number of visitors each year. Lundy supports an abundance of wildlife. Puffins perch on towering clifftops, and if you dive beneath the surface, underwater forests of giant kelp provide food and shelter for curious seals, fish, and spiny lobsters. In 2010, the rich waters surrounding the island became England's first marine conservation zone, recognized for the incredible marine creatures that thrive here, including corals, pink sea fans, spiny lobsters, Atlantic grey seals, and even passing basking sharks. The wealth of life supported by the seas around Lundy is reflected in the large community of seabirds living and breeding on the island. Populations of seabirds are showing signs of recovery, an indication of better management on land and at sea. Dean Jones is the warden at Lundy. He spends his day looking after the island, taking part in seabird surveys, running snorkel safaris, and ensuring each visitor has a memorable experience.
I've been on the island for 2.5 years now. Lundy is special to me, particularly with the wildlife here. Diving below the waves with the seals, you've got some really quite important marine habitats that support thousands of different marine creatures, which a lot of people love coming to Lundy to see. Oh, I love my job. Yeah, I mean, this is what I used to dream about when I was a kid. I always wanted to be a marine biologist. From there, I've learnt more about conservation and how me as a person, me as a human being, can actually impact the environment around me, and I can actually do a lot to benefit. We lead snorkel safaris throughout the summer season, which is one of the best parts of my job, is taking people out and showing them the wonders of the marine protected area here at Lundy and what we actually have under the water here in the UK. On the East Coast, it's the UK's first no-take zone as well, so no fishing whatsoever is allowed. It is really amazing what closing off in a really small area, and it's only 3.3 kilometres squared, is actually done for, you know, a commercially important species. And the overspill of lobsters into elsewhere into the marine protected area and actually outside the marine protected area here at Lundy, it's helping out the local communities too. You know, there are more lobsters out for them to catch there. So it is working, and we should be implementing more MPAs and more no-take zones around the country. The MPA is so important because it's protecting, you know, not only the wildlife out there, but our livelihoods as well. We have seen a real nice recovery with some of our seabird species here, in particular some of the burrow nesters like the puffins and the Manx shearwaters, and fingers crossed it's just going to keep going that way. It's really nice seeing nature thrive where it should be and probably always has been, but maybe affected at some point in the way by human interference. I like to think a lot of the work that we do here will inspire others too elsewhere in the country and further afield to protect what they have. I mean, it was one of the most important and one of the best parts of my job is being able to do that. I bless every day with it, I really do.
The waters around Lundy Island showcase some of the incredible life that can be found in our seas, highlighting the need for effective and well-managed marine protected areas. These areas can help to restore health and productivity to the surrounding ocean, giving nature and humankind an opportunity to flourish. Water connects every environment and living thing on the planet. How we use and manage water not only impacts nature, but also the people and businesses that depend on it. If you've been inspired to join in and take action to protect our environment, please visit the website to find out how.